Do something tricky and you're on the film. Grandfather, Great Spirit, fill us with the light, give us the strength to understand and the eyes to walk the soft earth as relatives to all that live. That's it.
That's because he's a baby and he needs to talk over everybody.
Oh, I thought you
he is.
The only way I could be fed was to be a little bit stronger, a little bit louder, because I had four in front of me. I was asked to write this, and to tell you the truth, I know everybody has their own memories of Cousin Betsy. So I could only pull off of those that I have, obviously, because I didn't survey everyone to put this together. So, you know, we've been blessed with two families coming together, making a very colorful legacy. Our grandparents, our aunts, our uncles, our cousins, all make up and play a perfect character in our history. Cousin Betsy was surely one of those characters.
Amen.
I'll drink that.
Being blown by a warm breeze off of Florida water, a bent fishing rod, and a glass of Dugan's Dew. That's how I see Betsy now. We all have specific memories of her, and we're very fortunate to have her so involved with us to share her life and stories these past several years. Some of mine I touch on now. I could never pick her up at the airport when she would be alone. Always escorted by airline personnel who wants to continue to talk to her all the way to putting the luggage in the car. People passing that was on the plane saying goodbye to her down in baggage claim because you know she was the life of the conversation on the flight east. I have maybe learned more from Cousin Betsy about the Nichols side of the family than anyone else other than Connie, just telling me stories that I never would have heard before, and I'm so thankful for that. What a life she led. Her stories are running around with the members and friends of the Delaware royal family, the DuPonts, dating gangsters and breaking their hearts. While the Broncos aren't worth a damn, Tebow got a raw deal. How there's a personal parking place at Chopper's, the bar across from her apartment, where she parked her Cadillac, her walker. that our grandfather saved her life and the family's life by running off their father, who was sure to kill the whole family. How we wouldn't know she was gone, but her and Billy had sneaked off to put a bet on the ponies during the family reunion. I never knew that her mother thought I wasn't worth a shit. If she didn't tell me.
Bad word. Really?
Sorry. There's only one more.
She was funny. I was just like her.
Showing Jeff the correct way to dance with Jamie on their upcoming wedding. He was doing it all wrong. She got up to show him how to do it right. And the wedding was a success, so she did a good job. The phone calls the camera telling me he should be sowing his wild oats and not be pinned down. And asking his 2-year girlfriend at dinner, which one was she? That was hysterical.
She's not here today, is she?
Not for Cameron, but that was hysterical. Her constant reminder how lucky I am to have the family I have. Her telling me what a wonderful life I have, what a wonderful wife I have, and I better not F that up, you little shit.
She's right.
This is so
I know we all have our own memories, and we're all fortunate for that. She had a favorite reason for spending time with each one of us as we shared her when she stayed in our area. She's thought the world of all of you. And look forward to this day, our family reunion and our traditions. So, raise your spirit, be it in glass or in your soul, to Cousin Betsy. We miss you, we love you, and thank you for adding some of the brightest color to our family.
Yeah.
Here, here.
Cheers.
Great job, Jeff. Great job.
Great job.
Okay, I think other people have things to say.
Tissue.
That was great. What? All right, come down a little.
Aunt Betsy, I miss you more than you will ever know.
Hey, make Jimmy mom.
I guess I never will. You are like a second mother to me. I could always count on you to say the right things to comfort me when I needed it. You cheer me up by just being there and talking through things. What a gift you had. I know I shouldn't still be crying, because this is not how you want it to be. You were up there, I know, entertaining all with that great spirit of fun that was just me. How lucky they are to have you. I reckon I'll be sad for a while, but someday I'll see you again. This I believe. Don't ever think I will stop missing you, because I won't. I miss our weekly calls. You always made me laugh. You're such a great part of my life. There truly is an emptiness in me that will never ever be gone. We've had so many good times together, tons of laughs as well. When you visited on vacation, I remember all the times we sat on my back porch, drinking scotch, and reminiscing of all the days gone by. She was such a wealth of information about so many things. I learned so much about my family. I also learned a whole lot about you and the wild and adventurous life you led. What a hoot. Aunt Betsy, I hope you know how much you will be missed and how much you were loved by so many. You will never, ever be forgotten.
Hear, hear.
Cheers.
But it still means a lot.
I thought of you today, but that is nothing new. I thought about you yesterday and the day before too. I think of you in silence, and Shirley and I often speak your name. All I have are memories and a picture in a frame. Your memory is a keepsake for which I'll never part. God has you in his arms, and I'll always have you in my heart. Thank you.
It's beautiful.
In my life.
Amen. I just want to say that it's because of Betsy's mother, Aunt Lola, or her name used to be Layla, but she changed it to Lola because she said what Lola wants, Lola gets. But anyway, because of her and Gwen's dad, Glenn, or we called him Bud, that's how we all ended up in Delaware. Because they talked Dad into coming to Delaware to get a job. And Dad came up and left Mom and Ron and me and Dennis down there. And then in August, after he had a job and found a place for us to live in Gordy Estates, that's when we moved to Wilmington. So you all are here because of Aunt Lola, Betsy's mother. And I love you, Betsy, and I miss you.
Yes,
cheers. Yeah.
experience.
Thank you, Lola. What Lola wants, Lola gets, even though she thought I wasn't worth it.
This is really a story. Every time Betsy stayed with us, we'd sit on the deck, drink, and I used to tell Connie when she'd go to bed, she's done everything. I just can't believe this shit. So one day I said to her, we were watching a movie about Komodo dragons. And she says, well, I know somebody that was killed by a dragon. I said, you do? Where were they at? She said, you were. So after she went to bed, I said to Connie, see what I'm talking about? So I Googled it. Well, lo and behold, in Newark, Delaware, in whatever year it wasn't a Komodo, but it was a dragon that killed an individual in his house. So I said, I'm going to believe everything she tells me. And then she tells me about she dated Santo Tropicani's hitman.
Yeah,
and
she took
and I said, Betsy, I can't believe this. Yeah, well, I did some research. In fact, she did date Santo Tropicani.
She did not know he was a hitman.
She didn't know he was a hitman. So the glove was on his hands. No. That, you know what? I don't miss a whole lot of people. My mom, dad, my family. I miss her. Yeah. I thought she should be
God bless.
God bless her.
God bless you.
Sunrise, I see the love in